Welcome back. In the previous session, we have briefly discussed about ideal sampling, sampling theorem and aliasing. And we have also discussed one tutorial problem on ideal sampling. That tutorial problem reveals you the difference between the sampling at the Nyquist rate, greater than the Nyquist rate and less than the Nyquist rate. As we already know, the sampling can be categorized into three different types. One is ideal sampling, then natural sampling, then flat top sampling. The difference between ideal sampling, natural sampling, flat top sampling lies in the sampling signal what we are going to choose. In the case of ideal sampling, we are using impulse train signal. Impulse train signal to sample the analog signal. But whereas in the case of natural sampling and flat top sampling, instead of impulse train, we are going to use pulse train. I hope you all know that impulse signal will be represented with an amplitude of 1 at time instant t is equal to 0. This is called as impulse signal. Similarly, if we go for representing a pulse signal, the pulse signal will have an amplitude for certain duration, and let me take this as the duration of the pulse. Let me can assume it as t. Okay, then the starting point will be t by 2 and the ending duration will be t by 2, and the pulse train should have the unit area. Then the amplitude should be 1 by t. This pulse train will be called as rectangular pulse. Hence, its duration is t. This will be called as rectangular function of t by capital T, where capital T denotes the duration of the pulse. So in the case of impulse sampling, we are going to use impulse train. For example, we will use impulse train having magnitude of 1 as a sampling signal. In the case of natural sampling, instead of this impulse signal, we are going to use the pulse train. Here also, the distance or the time gap between one sample and another sample is represented as TS, that is the sampling time period. The time gap between the center of two pulses is simply going to be considered as sampling time duration, TS seconds. Whereas the pulse duration, the duration of the pulse is going to play another role here, that is defined as capital T. Here the on a particular time instant alone, whereas here the pulse is having a duration of some t seconds. As we are unable to generate this impulse train in practical case, we cannot do ideal sampling. Hence, we are going for natural sampling, where the samples are going to be represented by some time duration. Both are having a similar nature, but at the output of the ideal sampling, we will have the sample amplitude at a particular time duration. But whereas in the natural sampling, it is having some finite amplitude for a finite duration, instead of by not representing it as a single time instant. This is the difference between the ideal sampling and the natural sampling. This rectangle function here can be represented as, and since it is repeated for every Ts seconds, this is Ts, this is 2 Ts, then the next pulse will present at 3 Ts, likewise it will go. As how we represent this as summation of k is equal to minus infinity to infinity del of t minus n Ts. Similarly, here also we are going to write this expression as summation of k is equal to minus infinity to infinity rectangular function of t minus n Ts by t. Sometimes the rectangular function can be written as pi of t minus n Ts by t. That we are going to see in the next slide. So natural sampling differs from ideal sampling in the way, in 3 different ways. That are, here the natural sampling is having a finite amplitude over a finite time duration. Then in the case of ideal sampling, we use the ideal low pass filter at the receiver side to reconstruct the analog signal. But whereas here we can use a practical low pass filter. For this specific, for the specification of a sampling duration and the bandwidth of the analog signal, based on that we can design a practical filter and we can able to reconstruct the original signal at the receiver. But in the case of ideal sampling, the signals are strictly to be band limited, whereas in the practical case, the signals assumed or not be band limited. So for that we need to say some consequences and some effects that we can discuss it in the later. The pulse, periodic pulse train can be represented as summation of rectangular function of t minus n Ts by t. Instead of rectangular function can also be represented as this form, pi of t. Okay, that's why here it is written as pi of t minus n Ts by t. It is a rectangular pulse function. As the rectangular periodic pulse train is a periodic signal, we are representing it with the help of exponential Fourier series. That is, p of t is equal to summation of n is equal to minus infinity to infinity cn e to the power of minus j 2 pi n of t. Whereas cn is the exponential Fourier series coefficient. To determine CL, we have to use this expression, that is minus TS by 2 to plus TS by 2. Since the pulse train is repeated depicted very clearly. Let me assume this as a analog signal. If you take Fourier transform of this analog signal, let me assume this will be the spectrum of this analog signal. And the periodic pulse time here, if you take the Fourier transform of this signal, the function is like a sinc function. This function is like a sinc function. So, if you sample it, you will get for this particular t duration, this is t, you can able to see the time gap between the pulse, the time duration of the pulse is t and the time gap between two pulses is ts.
Product modulator, or simply we can call it as a multiplier, to
to generate the sampled signal using the analog signal and the sampling signal as the input of the multiplier. But here we have to go for a different type of mathematical operation, that is, it is obtained by the convolution of the signal after ideal sampling with the unique amplitude rectangular pulse train. First we have to ideally sample it. We have to ideally sample it as per this expression. This is ideally sampled. Then this ideal sampled value is convolved with the periodic pulse train. We shall discuss the quantization process, that is the next step of the sampling process, to convert the discrete time signal into digital signal. That we will discuss it in the next class. Thank you.